full factorial designs are those designs in which we are performing experiments at all possible experimental runs, all possible combinations. Okay, and the full factorial designs will have a design space, the boundary which is covering the entire experimental area is called experimental domain, or the experimental boundary or experimental domain. So this full factorial designs will have the experimental domain which is having n dimensions, and that n is equal to number of factors. Jetla factor hase etla dimensions hase. So for an example, two level two factor design. This is a layout of two level two factor design in which all four experiments, they are at the corner and it makes a square. Okay, now how it makes the square, let me explain using another window. 1 minute, let me share with you a paint window so that you can better understand. So these are two axes. The horizontal axis we designate as x1 for an example, and the vertical axis we designate as x2. Okay, and the origin always is 0, 0, as you know. Okay, now if you move on the x1 axis, for an example over here, so this side is showing +1. Agree? This side you have studied already that it is negative. So if I move by 1 unit, it is -1. If on y axis, if we move upward, it is +1 or plus side, and if I move downward, it is -1 or minus side. Agree? Atlu badhane samjhai gayu chhe?
Yes, sir.
Good. Now, if I draw lines which are passing through this +1, -1, etc., etc., arbitrarily I am drawing lines, not with proper scale, but just for the understanding purpose. Okay, now when these lines intersect each other, what will be the coordinate of this point? અત્યારે જ્યાં કર્સર છે એ પોઈન્ટ ના કોઓર્ડિનેટ્સ કેટલા થશે કોઈ કહી શકે?
+1 +1.
That's good. +1 +1. Very good. Okay. Similarly, for other points also, we can get the coordinates. Agree? I am putting it by myself. This is -1 and +1. This point is having coordinates -1 and -1. And this point is having coordinates +1 and -1. Okay, so these four points are our experimental points. At present, what I've shown you in the image, these four points are my experimental points. Okay, and the area which is covering the part is called my experimental domain, the yellow area. Is called my experimental domain. So the experimental domain will have that much number of dimensions as that of the number of factors. Here we have two factors. So my experimental domain is square. If I'm having three factors, my experimental domain will be cubic, and so on. Okay. So for in full factorial designs, the experimental domain is having that much number of dimensions as that of the number of factors. Clear? And hence, as we are performing experiments at four corners, we can predict the response at any point within this experimental domain. Mind you, though I have not performed the experiment over here or over here or over here or over here, anywhere. Okay, but still, using the mathematical model equation which I have devised, I can determine the relationship between my I can determine the response using that equation, and that is called mathematical model. Okay, and that is the beauty of the experimental designs, that we can predict the response even at a point where we have not performed the experiment. So we can draw maximum conclusion with minimum experimental runs. And here the experimental runs are placed logically. If you look at the experimental runs, no experiment is being repeated. We are performing experiment at plus 1, plus 1, minus 1, plus 1, and minus 1, minus 1. No experiment is being repeated. Still, entire experimental domain is being covered by the experiments. And hence, we can draw maximum conclusion from with the minimum experimental runs. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Now let us move back to the presentation. So it's a 2:2 full factorial design in which we are having two levels, two factors. As I said earlier, I'm repeating that the full factorial designs are represented as level raised to factor, number of levels raised to number of factors. So we have two levels, two factors. So it will be 2:2 full factorial design. Here, there is important thing is coding. When we are performing the experiments, we cannot normally use the concentrations as it is. Say, I'm having the diluent binder concentration of 3% and 5%, disintegration concentration 4% and 6%. So I cannot use the numbers as such. I need to code them. And normally, the lower level is coded as -1, the upper level is coded with +1, and the middle one is designated as 0. What about coding other values, say 0.5 or -0.5, etc. So for that coding, we have some equations. For an example, here there is an example of lemonade. So lower value -1, higher value +1. In case of three level design, -1, 0 and 1. Okay. So coding is done using this equation. Coded value, that is actual minus average divided by average minus minimum. Okay, the actual value minus average value divided by average value minus minimum value. Now let me explain this with examples using MS Excel again. So I'm going to share the Excel sheet with you so that you can better understand. For an example, I have one ingredient that at lower level I'm using at 100 milligram, at higher level I'm using at 500 milligram. Okay, -1 level is 100, +1 level is 500. Okay, now if I want to code for 250 concentration, so this is my actual value. Okay, I want to find out the coded value for this. So as we know that the equation coded is equal to actual minus average divided by maximum minus average. Okay, or we can say average minus minimum, whatever we can use. maximum minus average. So in our case, it will be actual, that is 250. Average is, kilo to say average here? Students, on. 300, Jena, good. Okay, 250 minus 300 divided by maximum, that is 500 minus 300. Okay, so the coded value for that will be minus 0.25. Getting it?
Yes, sir.
Good. Let us try for 300. So I change the actual value over here from 250 to 300. It comes to zero. Wait for a minute, students. So if I want to code for 400, I can get in a similar way. Okay. In this similar way, you can go for decoding as well. For an example, I have coded value of minus 0.5, minus 0.5, and I want to decode it. So that also I can do. So minus 0.5 is equal to actual that I want. I don't have it at present. So actual minus 300 divided by 500 minus 300. So 1 minute. So I can shift the 500 minus 300, that is 200. So it will become 200 multiplied by minus 0.5. That is equal to actual minus 300. Agree? Now 300 is shifted towards the other side. So 300 minus 100 is equal to actual. Getting it? So my answer will be 200. Actual value will be 200 for coded value. Okay, students, so sorry, in similar way we can code for other values as well. Can you try by yourself or any question? Okay.
No, sir.
Good, good, Zil. Now I'm giving you one value. You need to code for 350. Okay, You try coding 350 students.
Yes, sir.
And in your final MCQ exams, there are chances that is coding may be asked in your final exam as well. Okay, it is one of the best MCQ, which normally the examiners will love to ask. And it is easier as well. That's why they may be in your final MCQ exam as well.
Point 25.
Point 25. Okay,
yes.
Let me check. Yes, it will be point 25. Good, very good. Okay, so nice. Now you can code. Similarly, you can decode as well. If you want to decode, for an example, 0.5. Okay, try decoding 0.5. Very good. Okay, then let us move ahead with the experimentation again. I hope you are getting it to very fast, so it's nice. Okay. Next is effect and coefficient. Whenever we are performing an experiment, we are coming across these two terms. First one, that is effect, and second is the coefficient. So effect is nothing but the average of the response at plus one minus average of response at minus one level for the same factor. Say I have performed 2:2 full factorial design, and I am changing the level from minus 1 to plus 1 by keeping x2 at minus 1 level. Again, I am changing from minus 1 to plus 1 by keeping x2 at plus 1 level. So there will be difference in the response. Now, the average change while keeping other factor constant is called the effect of that factor. Okay, average change of changing that factor is called the effect of the that factor, and it is calculated using the x1 is equal to 1 upon a plus ab minus 1 plus b. Okay, let me explain what is a, b, etc., etc. Again, we are switching to the Excel. So normally, whenever we are performing the experiments, you need to remember these rules for designing an experiment. Your first factor changes every experiment. The first factor changes every experiment. Your second factor changes every number of levels. And your third factor changes every level square, number of levels raised to 2, or in other words, we can say level raised to 0, level raised to 1, level raised to 2, and so on. Okay. One minute. Anything raised to 0, that comes to 1. And if I have two levels, then my first factor changes each experiment. That is 1, minus 1, 1, and minus 1. The second factor will change at every number of levels. So if I have two levels, for two experiments, it will remain minus 1. For two experiments, it will remain plus 1. If I have third factor, okay, then it will follow the same suit. But let us first discuss with the two factors and then I'll move ahead. So, 1 minute, sorry. First is always minus 1, minus 1. There is a mistake from my side. So, first experiment is always minus 1, minus 1. Now, if we can say the factor x1 is A, and factor x2 is B, factor x3 is C. If we follow this chronology, the first experiment is having both the factors at lower level. So, this experiment is designated as 1. The second experiment is having only x1, A, at a positive level, plus level. So, it is designated as A. Second experiment is only having x2 positive. So, it is designated as B. And third having both positive. So, it is designated as AB. Okay. If third factor is there, then third factor will change every level square. So, we have here two levels. So, 2 raised to 2, that is 4. So, for first four experiments, it will assume minus 1 value. For next four experiments, it will assume plus 1 value. And the x1, x2 will be in a similar way. That is, each experiment x1 changes, every two experiment x2 changes, and every x4 four experiments x3 changes. So, your third experiment is designated as C, fourth as AC. Sorry, yes. Fifth is BC, and sixth one is ABC. Clear?
Yeah, sir.
Good. Now, let me explain how to solve these equations. Let us have, we have an experimental design like this. And we have a response, y. I'm writing over here. So, the value of y is like 10, 15, 25, and 30. For understanding purpose, I'm keeping all these values. So, your average response is called B0 or constant. Average of four responses is called B0. In our equation, we have B0. Now, in order to find out B1, what you need to do is, we need to multiply this response with the X1 column. And you need to find out the total summation. Now, the half of this is called the effect. Okay, let me explain what is effect. So, by definition, effect is when we change the factor from minus 1 to 1 level. Okay, it is the average response when the factor is changed from minus 1 to plus 1 level, keeping other variables constant. Mind well, keeping all other variables constant. So, here there is only one variable, x2. So, in these two experiments, x2 is at minus 1. So, when we change x1 from minus 1 to plus 1, the change in response is of 5 units. Agree? 5 units no change. Pachu, ahiya, baki na 2 experiments ma, here the x2 is at plus 1 level. If I change it from x1 from minus 1 to plus 1, change in response is 5. Agree? So, this average change, that is called effect. The average is 5. 5 plus 5 divided by 2. Agree? or any question?
Yeah, sir, I agree.
Good. From x1 also we can have this same, for x2 also we can find out the similar kind of changes. For an example, in these two experiments, x1 is at minus 1 level and x2 is changed from minus 1 to plus 1. Okay, so the average change for x2, I'm writing over here, is 15 units. Oh, sorry, the change over here is 15 units. Agree? Then again, when x1 is kept at plus 1 and x2 is changed from minus 1 to plus 1, the change is 15. So the effect of x2 is 15. Clear? Okay. Now the coefficient is always half the effect when you are working with the two level. Okay, when you are working with the two levels, the coefficient is half the effect. It is because it is the average. You can find out by determining the average of this. Okay. So, equation that is for the effect of x1, as we have discussed, it was equal to the 1/2, sorry, 1/2 in bracket a plus ab minus 1 plus b. Now let me explain how this equation is derived. At a, first experiment, a x1 is at positive level, so for taking the change, we need to deduct 15 minus 10, okay, and again 30 minus 25. So what comes at as positive is a and ab. What comes as negative is 1 and b. So this equation shows that it is 1/2 a plus ab minus 1 plus b. Clear? સમજાય છે કે કઈ કન્ફ્યુઝન છે આમાં?
સર સમજાય છે.
વેરી ગુડ, સમજાય ગયું છે, ધેટ્સ ગુડ. નાઉ ધ કોએફિશિયન્ટ વિલ બી એક્ઝેક્ટલી હાફ ધ ઇફેક્ટ, ઓર ઇટ કેન બી સેડ ધેટ 1/4 a + ab - 1 + b. હવે કોએફિશિયન્ટ શું છે? તો કે કોએફિશિયન્ટ ઇઝ ધ ચેન્જ ઇન રિસ્પોન્સ. યસ રિયા, ડુ યુ હેવ એની ક્વેશ્ચન?
સર આ ઇફેક્ટ ઓફ x1 વર્ડ ઉપર એક્સપ્લેન કરો.
ફરીથી શેનું ઇફેક્ટ વાળું?
હા, ઇફેક્ટ ઓફ x1 લાસ્ટ માં 1/2 વાળું છે ને?
x1, ઓકે ઓકે, ઇફેક્ટ ઓફ x1 ધેટ ઇઝ ઇક્વેશન છે જે ધેટ ઇઝ 1/2 a + ab - 1 + b. ઓકે, સો વોટ વી આર ડુઇંગ ઇઝ વી આર ટેકિંગ ધ ડિફરન્સ ઓફ ધ રિસ્પોન્સ વેર a ઇઝ પોઝિટિવ એન્ડ વેર a ઇઝ નેગેટિવ. ઓકે, સો ધીસ ટુ એક્સપેરિમેન્ટ્સ a and ab, in which a is positive while b and ab, sorry, 1 and b, in which it is negative. Clear? So a plus ab minus 1 plus b. Similarly, for effect of x2 we can derive equation like this. It is 1/2 in bracket. What will be the equation? Come on, who will suggest? कौन कैसे आना मत इक्वेशन सू बन से जिल रिया तुम्हें कही सकसो
ना सर
बोलो नहीं कही सको जो अनामत इक्वेशन सू बन से
बी प्लस ए बी
माइनस
गुड बी प्लस ए बी माइनस वन प्लस ए ओके जहां ए पॉजिटिव हो ए आगर नेगेटिव हो पाचर बराबर लाइन इक्वेशन बनी गई क्लियर
ओके
नाउ The coefficient is half the effect. Actually, coefficient is the change in response when we change the factor by one unit. Okay? Coefficient is the change in response when we change the factor by one unit. Equation आपने जो ये तो तुमने समझा से. Equation में आपने शुरू करी है तो कि y is equal to b0 plus b1 x1 plus B2 X2 plus B12 X1 X2 बराबर આવી રીતે ઇક્વેશન બનાવીએ છીએ તો અહીંયા ઇક્વેશન માં તમે જોશો તો શું થશે તો કે જ્યારે આપણે રિસ્પોન્સ ને એક યુનિટ ચેન્જ કરીએ ફેક્ટર ને બરોબર ત્યારે તમારો રિસ્પોન્સ છે એ કેટલા યુનિટ ચેન્જ થશે એને કહેવાય છે એનો કોએફિશિયન્ટ Simply, I equation che, that is like y is equal to mx plus c. I equation tame line nu bhani gaya chho, barobar che? Aina jevu j equation che. Suppose, ahiya hu evu mukhu chu ke y is equal to 4x plus 3. I equation che. To, if I keep x is equal to 0, What will be the value of y? Y ની વેલ્યુ કેટલી થશે?
3.
Very good. Okay. If I keep x is equal to 1, y ની વેલ્યુ કેટલી થશે?
7.
Very good. So, એનો કોએફિશિયન્ટ 4 છે. કેમ? તો કે x ને મેં જ્યારે 0 થી 1, એટલે કે 1 યુનિટ ચેન્જ કર્યો, ત્યારે મારા રિસ્પોન્સમાં y માં કેટલા યુનિટનો ચેન્જ આવ્યો? તો કે 4 યુનિટનો. Barabar? That is why it is called its coefficient. Now, for effect, what we are doing is, we are changing from minus 1 to plus 1 level. Ketla unit no change aavyo?
0.
Kya thi 0 unit? Minus 1 thi plus 1 sudhi change kariye. Ketla unit no change tha?
2 units
નો ચેન્જ થયો બરોબર પેલું માઇનસ 1 થી 0 અને પછી 0 થી 1 બે યુનિટ નો ચેન્જ થાય એને ઇફેક્ટ કહેવાય એટલે લોઅર લેવલ થી હાયર લેવલ ઉપર લઈ જઈએ ત્યારે જે ચેન્જ આવે છે એને આપણે કહીએ છીએ ઇફેક્ટ અને જ્યારે એક યુનિટ નો ચેન્જ કરીએ અને જે ચેન્જ આવે છે એને કહેવાય છે કોએફિશિયન્ટ બરોબર છે એટલે કોએફિશિયન્ટ હંમેશા ઇફેક્ટ કરતા અડધો હોય ક્લિયર ओके गुड नाउ इंटरेक्शन टर्म ये जी आपने डिस्कस नहीं करी અત્યારે જ કરી દઉં છું ત્યાં આગળ પાછું આવશે જ બટ જસ્ટ ઇન્ટરેક્શન ફાઇન્ડ આઉટ કરવા માટે તમારે શું કરવાનું છે x1 મલ્ટીપ્લાઇડ બાય x2 સો સિમ્પલી એનું મલ્ટીપ્લિકેશન x1 મલ્ટીપ્લાઇડ બાય x2 નેને ડ્રેગ કરી દેવાનું એની ઇફેક્ટ ફાઇન્ડ આઉટ કરવા માટે તમારે x1 x2 ને y થી મલ્ટીપ્લાય કરવાના x1 x2 મલ્ટીપ્લાઇડ બાય y બરોબર સોરી મિસ્ટેક x1 x2 મલ્ટીપ્લાઇડ બાય y સો અહીંયા જે એવરેજ લેશો આ બધાનું એ તમારો રિસ્પોન્સ બરોબર છે એનો કોએફિશિયન્ટ થશે એવરેજ ઓફ ધીસ સો ઇન અવર કેસ ઇટ ઇઝ 0 એટલે કોઈ ઇન્ટરેક્શન નથી બરોબર છે ओके So it is zero. So there is no interaction. Okay. Now, if you look at the difference, अपने अगर जो difference लिखा था, हमारा जो सुने तो बनने में पांच ने पांच unit नो same difference आता तो x1 में, ने बनने में सरखा unit नो difference आता तो x2 में पंद्रह पंद्रह unit नो बरोबर આવું જ્યારે થાય ત્યારે સમજી લેવાનું કે ઇન્ટરેક્શન નથી પણ પ્રેક્ટિકલી દર વખતે એવું નહીં થાય અમુક વખતે એવું થાય કે અહીંયા રિસ્પોન્સ છે એ 33 આવે છે તો તો તમારી ઇન્ટરેક્શન ટર્મ ની કંઈક વેલ્યુ મળી સો હિયર યોર ઇન્ટરેક્શન ટર્મ ઇઝ 0.75 વેન યોર રિસ્પોન્સ ઇઝ નોટ શોઈંગ એડિટિવ ઇફેક્ટ દેટ ઇઝ 1 પ્લસ 1 ઇઝ નોટ ઇક્વલ ટુ 2 ઇટ મે બી ગ્રેટર ધેન 2 ઇટ મે બી લેસ ધેન 2 ઇન સચ કેસીસ યોર interaction term will be present. In other cases, your interaction term will be zero. So you will not find any coefficient of x1, x2 and it will be zero. So you can say that interaction is not present. And here the interaction is the statistical interaction or functional interaction. You might have studied this drug interactions in your pharmacology. For an example, cotrimoxazole, when they are co-administered, they are more effective. So effect increases, that is called synergism. Sometimes when two drugs are co-administered, the effect decreases, that is called antagonism. So in such cases, in experiments also, you may have additive effect or some antagonistic effect, and that is called the interaction. Clear?
Yeah, sir.
So we have discussed the effect coefficient. Now your effect may be positive or negative. If it is positive, it indicates that when you increase your factor, your response increases. If it is negative, it indicates if you increase your factor, your response decreases. But while comparing the effects, you must only focus on the magnitude and not the sign, not the direction. Barobar che? એટલે ધારો કે ઇફ યોર ડિસઇન્ટિગ્રન્ટ ઇઝ ડિક્રીઝિંગ ધ ડિસઇન્ટિગ્રેશન ટાઈમ બાય 30 સેકન્ડ્સ એન્ડ યોર બાઇન્ડર ઇઝ ઇન્ક્રીઝિંગ ધ ડિસઇન્ટિગ્રેશન ટાઈમ બાય 15 સેકન્ડ્સ સો ધ ઇફેક્ટ ઓફ ડિસઇન્ટિગ્રન્ટ ઇઝ માઇનસ 30 ઇફેક્ટ ઓફ બાઇન્ડર ઇઝ પ્લસ 15 વિચ વન ઇઝ મોર પ્રોમિનન્ટ
પ્લસ 30
પાર્ડન મનીષા
Plus 30 effect.
Plus what effect? Which one is more prominent?
Plus.
Disintegrant ni effect say minus 30. Binder is having effect plus 15. Which one is more prominent? Koni effect vadhare keva se?
Binder.
બાઇન્ડર ની નહીં કહેવાય ઓકે ધીસ ઇઝ ધ મિસ્ટેક વિચ વી કોમનલી એડમિટ બાઇન્ડર ઇઝ હેવિંગ પ્લસ 15 આઈ સેડ ધેટ વી શુડ નોટ લુક એટ ધી સાઇન વી ઓનલી શુડ એમ્ફેસાઇઝ ઓન ધી મેગ્નિટ્યુડ યોર ડિસઇન્ટિગ્રન્ટ ઇઝ રિડ્યુસિંગ બટ બાય 30 યુનિટ્સ દો ઇટ ઇઝ નેગેટિવ બટ ઇટ ઇઝ બાય 30 યુનિટ્સ So if I increase the disintegrant by one unit, there will be more effect on the disintegration time. That is of 30 units. While if I change the binder by one unit, there will be less effect. That is only 15 units. So effect of disintegrant is more prominent, not that of the binder. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So again, moving ahead. This is an example which we already discussed. The factor x1, x2, result of analysis is explained over here. Here there is interaction term. So the effects of factor x1, x2 and x1, x2 are represented in a bar chart. Here we can see that the effect of x2 is more prominent. That is, it is having higher effect on the response. And if we change the x2, there will be more change in the response. Sometimes the effect may be positive or negative. On other side, they may be there. You only should look at the height of the bar, not the side. direction upar jovanu nahi, height upar jovanu. Jeni height vadhare hoy, that is more prominent. Next is three level two factor design. If you have any question in this two level two factor design, you can ask. Okay. So next is a three level two factor design. We have still two factors, and that's why our experimental domain is only two dimensional. But we have three levels. So third level has been incorporated, that is zero. So we have total four corner points, four centers of the sides, and one overall centroid, and that will construct a three level two factor design. Here the combination will be let me explain in Excel again, 1 minute. અને આગળ ઉપર તમને બાકી છે એક વસ્તુ ધેટ વિલ ઓલસો આઈ લાઈક આઈ વિલ એક્સપ્લેન. સો એઝ વી હેવ ડિસ્કસ્ડ થર્ડ ફેક્ટર ચેન્જીસ એવરી લેવલ. નાઉ ઇફ આઈ વોન્ટ ટુ કન્સ્ટ્રક્ટ ધ ડિઝાઇન ફોર ટુ ફેક્ટર્સ થ્રી લેવલ્સ. So first experiment changes every level, every experiment, minus 1, 0, 1, minus 1, 0, 1, minus 1, 0, and 1. Second experiment will change every number of levels. So here we have three levels. So for three experiments, it will remain minus 1. For three, it will remain 0. For three, it will remain 1. So by this way, you can construct the design. Okay, clear. Now here we have total 9 experimental runs, 3:2, that comes to 9. So we have 9 experiments. Here if we have factor 3, x3, then it will remain constant for 9 experiments, and for again 9 experiments it will assume the value 0. For next 9 it will assume the value of plus 1, and we have total 3 raised to 3, that is 27 experiments. Clear?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
So this is the combination, minus 1 minus 1, 0 minus 1, 1 minus 1. Now those values which are having 0, that are on any axis, okay, any one axis. So the coefficient of one factor will be 0, and rest will be either plus 1 or minus 1. So this is the layout of three level two factor design. Four corner points, four centers of the sides, and one overall centroid, that is 0, 0. This is 2:3 full factorial design, that is two level three factor design. We have three factors, and that's why this design is three dimensional design. It's a cubical design, and we have 8 experimental points that are the corners, 8 corners of a cubic cube, 8 corners of a cube, and that will construct a design. Similarly, 3 level 3 factor design, 3 factors, 3 levels. So we have 8 corner points, 6 centers of the sides, 6 centers of the sides, 12 centers of the edges, 12 centers of the edges, and one overall centroid. So it comes to 5, sorry, 8 plus 6 plus 12 plus 1, that is total 27 experiments are there. Clear?
Yes sir.
Okay.
Yes sir.
Now interaction. So we already discussed, that is what is interaction. Interaction is the change in the response when we are changing both the factors at a time. That is, effect is not additive. It is other than additive effect. And it can be determined using two techniques, either graphical method or mathematical model. So this is an experimental design without interaction. Here, there are two factors, catalyst concentration and temperature. They are performed at low level and high level, and the response is represented as 10, 25, 30 and 45, as we have discussed earlier. So in mathematical model, the interaction term will have the value A plus D minus B plus C, because interaction term can be calculated using this equation, or in other words, 1 plus AB minus A plus B in our terminology. So here the coefficient of the interaction term is 0. That is why it is absent. Using graphical representation, what we need to do is, we need to plot the graph of any one response, find one factor and response. Any one factor on x-axis and response on y-axis. So, for lower level of the second factor, we will get one line. For higher level of that factor, we will get second line. Now, if two lines are parallel to each other, okay? If two lines are parallel to each other, where will they intersect each other? Where will they touch each other? Anyone? जो बे लाइन एक बीजा ने पैरेलल होए तो एक बीजा ने क्या टच कर से कई जगह टच कर से क्या था तो क्या टच ना टच था था ना था इस सके गुड जील ये क्या रे टच ना था इस सके बरोबर छे दे विल नॉट टच ईच अदर दे विल नॉट इंटरसेक्ट ईच अदर एंड इट इंडिकेट्स देयर इज नो इंटरेक्शन ओके सो इफ बोथ द लाइंस आर पैरेलल टू ईच अदर देयर इज नो इंटरेक्शन ओके दिस इज एन एग्जांपल विद इंटरेक्शन सो हियर द कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ योर इंटरेक्शन टर्म इज other than zero, and hence the interaction is present. Okay, effect of your coefficient is other than zero, and so the interaction is present. Similarly, it can be studied using graphical method. If you look at the lines closely, they are not parallel to each other, and if you extrapolate these lines, somewhere in the universe they will touch each other. Somewhere in the universe they will touch each other, so it shows there is interaction. Clear? So by this we can detect the interaction. Second thing is non-linearity. Sometimes the response is not linear. Now when we are working with the two levels, we cannot detect the non-linearity. Mind well, when we are working with the two levels, we cannot detect the non-linearity. Let me say that I put one point anywhere in this slide and second point anywhere in the universe, where will this touch each other? Will these two points be linear or not? One minute. Say here I have a point over here, and I put another point anywhere on this slide. क्या मुकी दोगे में दें? Are these two points linear?
No sir.
Huh? Yes or no?
No.
No. Okay. Anyone else? Are these two points linear? Obviously linear. Okay, I can draw a straight line connecting these two points. જ્યાં પણ આ એક પોઈન્ટ અહીંયા મૂક્યો સપોઝ અને બીજો પોઈન્ટ હું ગમે ત્યાં મૂકી દઉં ગમે ત્યાં એનીવેર આઈ કેન ઓલવેઝ કનેક્ટ ધીસ ટુ પોઈન્ટ યુઝિંગ અ સ્ટ્રેટ લાઈન બરોબર છે એટલે બે પોઈન્ટ હશે ને તો હંમેશા એ લિનિયર જ હશે હજી કોઈને કન્ફ્યુઝન છે કે સમજાય છે?
સમજાય છે.
ઓકે, સો ઇફ વી હેવ ટુ પોઈન્ટ્સ વી કેન નોટ પ્રિડિક્ટ નોન લિનિયારિટી. એટલે મારી પાસે જ્યારે ત્રીજો પોઈન્ટ હોય, ધારો કે આ બે પોઈન્ટ્સ છે, પોઈન્ટ એ અને પોઈન્ટ બી, બરોબર છે, આ બંને એક જ લાઈનમાં છે, પણ જ્યારે કોઈ ત્રીજો પોઈન્ટ સી આવે ત્યારે મને ખબર પડશે હવે કે આ ખરેખર એક લાઈનમાં જાય છે કે નહીં, બરોબર છે. એ ત્રીજો પોઈન્ટ અહીંયા પણ હોઈ શકે, અહીંયા પણ હોઈ શકે. એટ ધેટ ટાઈમ આઈ મે કમ ટુ નો વેધર દે આર લિનિયર ઓર નોટ. ક્લિયર?
યસ સર.
ગુડ. સો ઇન ઓર્ડર ટુ અસેસ નોન લિનિયરિટી વી મસ્ટ વર્ક એટ લીસ્ટ એટ થ્રી લેવલ્સ. એટ લીસ્ટ વી શુડ હેવ થ્રી લેવલ્સ, ધેન એન્ડ ધેન ઓનલી વી કેન ચેક વેધર નોન લિનિયરિટી ઇઝ પ્રેઝન્ટ ઓર નોટ. એન્ડ નોર્મલી ધ નોન લિનિયર રિલેશનશીપ્સ આર રિપ્રેઝેન્ટેડ બાય ધી એક્સપોનેન્શિયલ ટર્મ્સ. ઓકે, વોટ ઇઝ ધી ઇક્વેશન ઓફ અ સર્કલ? As there is equation for a line y equals mx plus c. Okay. What is the equation for a circle? Is x square plus y square that is equal to r square, because circle is a set of points which are at equal distance from the center, and that distance is equivalent to radius. That distance is called the radius. So the circle is the collection of the points which are situated at the distance r from the center of that circle. Agree? So if you connect all the dots which are at the distance r from the center, we will get a circle. In any kind of non-linear shape, we require an exponential term, at least one or more exponential terms. X square. Okay?
Sir, you are not audible.
Okay, so sorry for interruption. Wherever there is non-linearity, we must represent using any exponential term. So you require either x square or y square, etc., etc. For parabola, for hyperbola also, you are knowing the equations. So when your response is not changing linearly, then it is called non-linearity. And in order to assess the non-linearity, we must act at least work at a